a better Nigeria as possible, the importance of leadership, citizenship and integrity in national life. I am going to give a glimpse into the dysfunctional Nigeria with which we are all disenchanted with just 10 scenarios. I'll just mention 10 scenarios. One, we want a better Nigeria, but we need Nigeria to organize conferences in other countries of the world where all attendees, facilitators, speakers and consultants are all from Nigeria. But we go and organize it in Dubai, and we go and organize it in the US. We reject everything that is made in Nigeria, both the private and public sector, in favor of the bad, the good and the ugly, insofar that that is labeled foreign. Contracts are awarded to foreigners. Briefcase, those are called portmanteau contractors, to the neglect of local national contractors. And I ask a question. NNPC, the oil majors, we have the local content. What is wrong in using our money to train our people? When they make mistakes, they will learn from it. 70% of contracts are still done outside. So what is wrong in using our money to train our people? Why must we give P&I discount? We are all witnesses to it. $9.6 billion. For a man who did not dig anything, for a man who did not carry anything, for a company that has no track record, $9.6 billion. If the thief in the house is not there, the thief outside cannot steal. It is because there is compromise inside. That is why there will always be compromise. You need to go and read the judgment of the UK court in relation to the application brought by Nigeria for you to know how the world is looking at us. We hero worship violators and deviants on account of wealth, which we all know by illegally amassed and ill-gotten. Listen to what Pius Adesanya of Desert Memory said in an article he titled, "Ladies and gentlemen, please rise up to recognize the presence of thieves." He said, "The day you develop the courage to stop recognizing the presence of known thieves in your public and social ceremonies, we will have started our long journey to civilization." The fifth one, we invest in infrastructure development that lacks quality and integrity. We deliberately invest in these things that we know are lacking. Sir, go and check. You know, when green technologies came, Nigeria saw opportunity in it. To go and they went ahead and bought things that were substandard. And that is why all our streets are littered everywhere with abandoned solar lights that are not working. They knew that these things were bad, but they were cheap and they knew they will rape the country. And they were doing it. It will shock you that even vaccine that has just come, I read it in the news, it was on the rise. Ikoyi touts will kill. The way it used to be at the embassies in times of old, when touts will go and take numbers, tally numbers. Touts will kill and take tally numbers. And then those who come in regularly and kill will not be vaccinated. But those who will leave their houses at 10, 11, 12 will go there and beat the touts. Working together with health officials. Come on! What are we talking about? And we want Nigeria to be good. I also talked about road repairs is rocket science in Nigeria with variation upon variation. Several discarded ICT infrastructure, newly constructed buildings that can only serve the purpose of activities of the 1970s and 1980s. I went to court in one of the states. I will not mention the name of the state. They built their high court just about 4 or 5 years ago. When we were walking inside the court premises, I asked somebody, I said, "When was this place built?" He said, "About 4 years ago." I said, "Oh my goodness." People wasted money. Because I am sure in the 1970s, they would think twice building that kind of edifice. In the 1970s. And that was what we built 4 years ago. Coercion and extortion of private sector participants by government officials and inducement of government officials by private sector participants. High-level infringement, yet lacks enforcement, and at times, deliberate non-enforcement. It is for this reason that seemingly small but critical infrastructure, such as traffic lights and zebra crossing, that are aimed at facilitating safety of road users, and which are hugely impactful in Benin Republic, are not much of significance in their impact in Nigeria, because laws are not enforced. When I was coming in here this afternoon, as I was about to turn in into Radisson, this vehicle was coming behind me with the Mupola and the rest of them banging my door, move, and he was telling me I should go. I said, I'm going in here. I said, no, go. I said, this is them. I said, no, just go. Just because of 1 minute delay, because I was going to turn in, I did not move. I insisted that that is where I'm going to turn, although with petition in my heart, because I felt, if he decides to use the boot of the gun, what will I do? But he shows you the kind of thing that do to ourselves. And I'm very sure, in my heart of heart, the person that will be in that vehicle will just be in the company. That is the kind of problem with this. Excessive delays. Number 8, excessive delays in administration of justice. We don't need to go far at all. Why will this not be? The latest disclosure by the president of the NPA is a summary of the vicissitudes that are yet to come. I didn't know. The vicissitudes are coming. Listen to this. He noted, what I saw and experienced at the NJC meeting on the appointment of judges to the Court of Appeal left me aghast. At a point, I had to ask, are these people really going to the Court of Appeal? Important legal issues that were occasionally put to the nominees could not be answered. When I wondered at this, I had things like, they will land on the job. The Court of Appeal judge. They will land on the job. We were to interview 20 nominees at a point, but only 2 hours was allocated for this important exercise. That meant 6 minutes only for each nominee. Collapse of infrastructure across sectors. Insecurity has become the order of the day. I don't need to give examples. We all know. When you eat your food, when you are going home, pray. Sheikh has said it. Pray so that you get home safely. Amen. You all know. And when you listen to the exchange between Governor Otom and Governor of Bauchi State, you begin to ask yourselves, where are we going? On and on we can go. We all know the story. Permit me to know that these issues are not confined to any particular administration. They have been a part of us for some time, but they deepened in the early 1980s. Those are the 10 scenarios. I now come to, how did we get here? 4 excuses we give ourselves. We talk about the colonial rule and colonial master's theory. After how many years? Colonial rule, colonial masters, after how many years? Dubai was just 25, 30 years ago. We talk about the globalization and exploitation theory, dominance of the developed north. What are we talking about? You have appointed your leaders. They have appointed their leaders. Are their leaders supposed to be watching your own country? Your leaders are to watch your country. Their leaders are to watch their country. There will always be global politics. Even in our respective houses, politics thrive. We are a young democracy theory. The number of years it took developing nations to arrive at current stage. I agree that we are a young growing democracy. But the question is, there are some basic things that are not rocket science. Basic things of giving electricity, giving water, giving the basic amenities of life. Those ones are not rocket science. You don't need to be Methuselah on earth before you can achieve those things. It simply smacks of a seriousness in leadership. Number four, ethnicity theories. And I simply ask myself, are any of the ethnic groups united within themselves? The malady that is Nigeria, when we break up into ethnic groups, the malady will continue in the different ethnic groups. Truth be told, we are a nation of excusiologists. We blame every other person and things, animate and inanimate, but ourselves for our own challenges. And I move on and I say, we are all guilty in the macabre dance of death into which we have played, clung our dear nation. And I ask the following questions. How faithful are we to our role as citizens? What is not an option for Nigeria? And we must not push for it. The way forward. One, leadership that is fair, but fair and just, both in distribution of rewards and punishment. There must be equity in development. And I commend Professor Atahiru Jega's posture on true federalism. Atahiru Jega was very clear on low-hanging fruits and then how we should move forward in terms of how we manage the constitution. With all the reports that we have on ground, it is doable. Two, leadership must be keenly interested in enabling strong institutions that can drive clear focus, deliberate, purposeful, and consistent policy. It is not rocket science, it is very possible. And I've noted it earlier, the leader must start with making scapegoats of violators. Where you don't make scapegoats of violators, impunity will continue. And for as long as citizens are seeing impunity in leadership, they will never toe the line.